Hello friends, today I am going to talk about the convalescent blood plasma therapy. So before starting this talk, I would like to make one thing very clear that this is not some new technique that has been designed specifically for the treatment of COVID-19 or the SARS COV2 infection. This technique is around a century old and was used specifically in one of the world's worst pandemic, that is the Spanish flu of 1918. Which killed almost 500 million people or 5% of the world's population. WHO also recommended its use during the Ebola virus outbreak or the SARS outbreak of 2003 and H1N1 swine flu outbreak of 2009. So whenever a new disease strikes us, we generally use this technique, that is the blood plasma therapy. Now in case of COVID-19, this technique has also shown some promising results in the trials that have been done in United States, India and some other countries. So, before starting with blood plasma therapy, you should first know what actually blood is. In layman's term, blood is something which is red in color, contains hemoglobin, pumped by the heart and transports oxygen to different parts of the body. But blood is more than that. It contains many components. So, if we take out blood from a person and want to see its different fractions, we use a technique called as centrifugation, which gives us different fractions of the blood. Now let's have a look at the video clip of centrifugation.
Blood is separated by using a centrifuge, a process in which the blood is rapidly spun so the heavier red blood cells and plasma will separate. A second spin settles the platelets and the plasma can be removed to isolate the platelets. When the bags are removed, the components have settled in layers with red blood cells at the bottom and platelet-rich plasma at the top. A thin line of white blood cells and platelets is also visible at the top of the red blood cells.
The topmost layer that you are seeing is called as plasma. It is pale yellow in color. The middle layer, it contains the leukocytes and WBCs, and the bottom layer, it contains the RBCs, that is the erythrocytes. So in terms of equation, plasma is something which is whole blood minus the RBCs minus the platelets minus the WBCs. Now I think you must have understood what whole blood is and how plasma is separated from it. Now you are ready to move forward and understand what actually blood plasma therapy is. As the term itself contains blood plasma, so we are interested only in the plasma part of the blood. So the next question arises, what the magical thing this plasma contains that when transferred to an infected person cures the disease? The answer is the antibodies. So if you have seen my first video in which I have described the rapid antibody test for identifying the presence of coronavirus, I have told that whenever our body is infected by some pathogen, that is a microbe or a virus, our body produces antibodies to fight that pathogen. And these antibodies are highly specific for that pathogen. You can consider that our immune system is like an army. Whenever a terrorist infiltrates, it tries to kill the infiltrators by producing antibodies. These antibodies remain or reside in the blood plasma. So that is why we are interested in the plasma part of the blood for the blood plasma therapy. So at this point you have understood what blood plasma is and what are antibodies. Now let's move to the procedure, that is how the blood plasma therapy is done actually. For this procedure we need a donor and a recipient. Now who can be a donor? As I am making this video specifically in context to the COVID-19 infection, a donor is someone who has recovered from this infection and has not shown any symptoms for at least 14 days and has also tested negative by the PCR test. And apart from this, the person should be in good health. He must have a body weight of at least 60 kgs and free from any transfusion transmitted infectious diseases like hepatitis A, B, C, HIV and syphilis. And one more important thing is that the antibody titer. should be above a certain threshold. Antibody titer is the amount of antibodies present in the plasma. It should be above a certain threshold to be used. Now let's talk about who is eligible recipient. At this point, this procedure has not been recognized as a standard treatment by WHO or US FDA or the ICMR. And this treatment is still in the trial phase or the experimental phase. So the allowed recipients are only the laboratory confirmed COVID-19 patients who are critically ill, that is, who are on ventilators or are in the ICUs. Now we know the eligible donors and the eligible recipients. We can move forward to how this technique is done. For doing the blood plasma therapy, we use something called as plasmapheresis. Now what is plasmapheresis? In this technique, the blood is transferred to an automatic machine also called as a separator, which separates the blood into plasma and the remaining components, that is the red blood cells, platelets and the WBCs. These remaining components are transferred back into the patient's body and plasma is collected in a sterile bag. Generally, plasma required for 3 treatment doses is taken from a single donor, and around 700 ml of plasma can be collected in one go from a single donor. And the time duration between 2 plasma donations should be at least 14 days. So let's have a look at the video clip of how it is actually done. After the plasma collection, it is immediately stored at minus 20 degrees Celsius and can be used when required and stored up to a year or up to 3 years. This plasma can be given to a compatible patient by doing the ABO blood typing. This step is very, very necessary. That is, the plasma should only be given to a compatible patient so as to avoid any reaction from the plasma into the recipient, which can cause life threatening conditions as well. So friends, I think you must have enjoyed and learned something from this video. And if you want me to continue making these type of videos, please like, share and subscribe my channel.